Good morning and welcome to the last edition of the Daily Devotions from the Farm in South Georgia. We're still going to have some daily devotions for you, but we're heading back north today and try to get back home in the next couple of days. I hear that Kentucky's shutting their border, so who knows? We might have to do a little Dukes of Hazzard to get out back home, but I'm sure we'll make it. I want to share this scripture with you. It's in Lamentations chapter 3, verse 22 through 23. I know you know it well. It says, through the Lord's mercies, we are not consumed. Aren't you glad for God's mercy this morning? Hallelujah. Because His compassions fail not. Even when our compassions are gone, our mercies are gone, His are not. Verse 23, they are new every morning. It is a cool morning here in South Georgia. It's like 48 degrees, feels like home. But His compassions, His mercies are new every day. They're new again today. We're praying and believing God for His mercy. Great is your faithfulness. Great is, it reminds me of that song, Great is Thy Faithfulness, O God. I want to tell you, in addition to that scripture, when we're talking about mercy and grace, I want to tell you about a movement among churches that is worldwide called the Prayer 714, if you've not heard of it yet. It's based on 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sin and heal their land. And that's what we're praying, God, to heal our land. But every day at 7:14 in the morning and 7:14 at night, you can maybe set your alarms on your phones or on your clocks to remind yourself to pray. People worldwide are praying. Now, I know we're just in the Eastern time zone, but at 7:14, 24 hours a day, people are praying. And here's the prayer. I'm just going to close this devotion with this prayer. I want you to listen closely to the words. And you can find this prayer online and print it out. But if you'll unite with us, I believe millions and millions, billions, literally, of Christians around the world can pray this. And we can see the demise of the coronavirus, which is what we're praying. But I'm going to pray this prayer now, and I want you to join me. It says, Lord, we humble ourselves before you today in prayer. Our hearts are saddened by the reports coming from our own nation and around the world of the continued spread of the devastation of COVID-19. Today, we draw near to your throne of grace in confidence and faith, knowing you will hear our prayer for those mercies we just talked about that are new every day. Your word says that though we were a people who once were in darkness without you, you were merciful to us and called us out of darkness and into your marvelous light. You made us a royal priesthood, a holy nation. We talked about that yesterday. You are a God who is full of mercy, compassion, and grace. We just talked about that in Lamentations. You said we can receive mercy in our time of need. We need your help. We cry out to you because our world is in a desperate place. Coronavirus or COVID-19 has created a dire time of need, but we are standing in faith on the promises of your word. Today we are believing that as you appointed the Old Testament priests to stand in the gap as intercessors to see plagues and disease eradicated, so you will use the church today to intercede and see COVID-19 eradicated from the earth. I talked about that in devotion yesterday. Therefore, we stand together as your royal priesthood and take authority over COVID-19 virus. We pray COVID-19 will be eradicated. The victims will be healed. The doctors, nurses, scientists, and first responders and all the vulnerable will be protected. We ask all these things in your name, Jesus. Amen. So I want to encourage you to pray this prayer twice a day at 7:14. Print it out on your computer. Pull it up. It's out there. Christians worldwide are praying it. Remember, His mercies are new every morning. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.